Sarvapalli Radhakrishna's birthday was on 5th September. Since it was on Sunday, our principal has suggested us to have it juxtaposed today. And over to Dr. Girisha C., our beloved principal. Yes.
So good morning, everyone. So happy Engineers Day. As mentioned earlier, happy belated Teachers Day.
Thank you. Thank you.
So we are privileged because we have been given with two responsibilities, ultimate responsibilities, being a teacher and also an engineer. So we have greater roles to play and also greater responsibility to have. So I would like to welcome our today's speaker, Dr. Shashi Shankar, HOD of Civil Engineering, AIIMS Engineering College. Welcome, sir. And also in the absentia, I would like to welcome Dr. K. Mallikarjun Babu, sir, who is the director and head of AIIMS Institutions. I welcome all the heads, the faculty members, the students, and other invitees, especially the invitees called by Dr. Shashi Shankar, sir. Welcome, sir. Welcome to this small webinar, in which our beloved Dr. Shashi Shankar, sir, will try to highlight the significance of both teachers as well as engineers day as such. So these sort of things, arranging the seminars, webinars, is done by none other than our beloved sir, Dr. Shashi Shankar, sir. Sir, kindly continue with this saga. Okay, sir. So once again, on behalf of the AIIMS Engineering College, I welcome all heads, Shashi Shankar, sir, students and faculty members. Thank you, sir. Shashi Shankar, sir, you can continue, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Girish.
Thank you, sir.
For such a nice introduction.
And
I'm very small person. In fact, to talk about the two giants. However, I just make an attempt to write highlight their achievements so that the people at least will know that why September is a significant month and why September 5th and September 15th are great days for teachers and engineers.
Thank you, sir.
I just start with a prayer. Jayanti te sukrutinaha, jayanti te sukrutinaha, rasa siddhaha kavishwaraha, rasa siddhaha kavishwaraha, nasti esham yashakaye jara maranajam bayam. What do you mean by this? This is the Vedic saying, jayanti te sukrutinaha. People will be remembered even after their death. Even after their death. What kind of people will be remembered even after their death? So that is, jayanti te sukrutinaha, rasa siddhaha kavishwaraha. The great workers of humanity, the great poets, the great talented people, correct, who have worked for the human beings, the other fellow beings. So they will be remembered ever, even after death, right? So you have seen whether it is Jesus after 2000 years, the Moses or whatever it is, or Krishna, Rama, all these people, right? Whether it's the 8,000 years or 3,500 years, they will be remembered for their virtues and for their great work for humanity. So anybody is going to work for humanity, right, will be remembered forever. And he may not be a very rich man, or he may not be identified as a poor man too. So it doesn't really matter. But working for humanity has been the hallmark of great people, and they will ever be remembered. And September month is a great month which has given two such stars for the entire world, not for the nation. You should really believe this, correct? This, if I say, will not be right, appropriate. But if United Nations says, this will become appropriate. And if my neighboring country says, it will become appropriate. If the subcontinent says, it will become appropriate. If US people say, it will become appropriate. If Stalin says, it will become appropriate. Who are those two people who were honored, right, the entire world? they are two people, there are two people, right? So one is born on 5th of September and the other is born on...
Yeah, hello sir, good morning. This is Dr. Rakshit from Amity Business School, Mumbai. And I was just getting through being a faculty of IT. I was looking through. It was really, adorable. And it was really so enriched and
so nice. Thank you. No, I'm really right. I think I had the good fortune of having people connecting from Detroit and Washington also. And Dr. Rampur Vishwanath had called me, and from Detroit, we have the aerospace managing director has called me, and it shows their great Philip and energy to join with the wavelength of the great people, the duo, what you call the September duo, we call them, that is Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan and Saram Vishweshwaraya, right? Both were there is a similarity between the two duo. That is, one is, both were born on September, right, month, one on 15th, that is Saram Vishweshwaraya, and fifth, the other on 5th of September, that is Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan, and both were, the mother tongue is Telugu, Teluguites, basically Teluguites, and from the Mulakanado Brahmin, sect, very poor family, both were very poor family, or the one is worshipper of Anjaneya temple and the other one is right in Karnool temple, correct? And another one, of course, in Tirutani, right? So in Tirupati. So, and these people are basically, right, born into a very poor family, that is utter poverty is their gift, birth gift, we can call them. So what happens here is that was the plus point. So poverty was the plus point for these two people, but they had a great background. They cherished a great background. What was the background, right? So if I just consider these two people, one is Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan, was born in Tiruttani into a Telugu family, but in the Madras province. It was at that time, right, in Madras province, Tiruttani. It is just bordering Tirupati. It is now in Andhra Pradesh, we can call it. So he was born into a very chaste family where his mother was interested in Sanskrit and father was interested in French and English. And this is what made into Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan. So he was encouraged to take up French language by his father, and mother encouraged him to take up the Sanskrit language. So he could incorporate all the religious texts of the world, whether it is Vedas, he is a scholar in all the Vedas, and of course, right, Islam, right? He is a scholar in Islamic tradition, and he's a scholar in Christianity. He's a scholar in all the religions. So he is basically a doctor of philosophy and a great educationist. He himself became a great teacher. And though he was not into any Congress party or whatever it was Jawaharlal Nehru who liked him, right, and made him the vice president of this country, the first vice president of this country, he was made into, right? And before that, he was also deputed as the ambassador to USSR, when Stalin was there. And everyone was afraid of Stalin those times because he was a dictator. And anybody, reporting to Stalin would be very much afraid. Even if something wrong happens, they would be killed. So that's the kind of man he was. He's a staunch communist. And you believe me or not, Sarvapalli was deputed from India and as the first ambassador to USSR. And Sarvapalli goes and he reports to Stalin in a very different manner than any other country ambassador would do. His stature itself was very, very diplomatic and disciplined. And he goes and he smiles at Stalin and slaps him on the cheek like this. Slaps him on the cheek of Stalin like this. This is the introduction that he made on behalf of India. And Stalin started laughing and laughing and laughing. Why did he laugh? Because the whole world considered him as a monster, and they were afraid of him. And whereas one great person from India, that is Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, goes and slaps that kind of a monster without fear or favor, My dear friend, this makes him laugh and laugh. And Stalin says, for the first time, right in the world, correct, somebody has considered me as a human being, that is Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. So this shows that first, you have to be a human being. You know VTU, VTU emblem, you know, if you just go and observe in the emblem underside, what is our logo saying? That is, Madalu Manavanago, that is what Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan tells, right? Be a human being first, not anything. And that is what he has preached. And today we have to really learn this. We have to relearn this, and we have to unlearn the other monstrous kind of a ideology that we have in our brains. So this is about this. And he being a great educationist, right, I want to just remember one small thing. Today, we are talking about the educational technologies. Yes, today we are talking about online education. My dear friends, right, I will give an example of my meeting, right, of my father's meeting in 1958. My father, I was not born at that time, right, and my father's meeting in Delhi with Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. Please note that a few of them went from the Mysuru College, correct, and B.Ed. College, Mysuru, and they met Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. I have a photo of them where Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan is showing a TV. 1958, I'm talking a television, and he is explaining to these teachers who are going to be the budding teachers how to teach online, using a TV, television. So please note, this is 1958. At that time itself, he had forethought that online education and blended education should be the right idea for the future. And today is 2021. And today we are talking about online education. So you can see that is the difference between a great visionary and the others. And the other man is Sir M. Vishweshwaraya, who was born on 15th of September. And please note that he came from a legacy of a Purohit family from Karnulu. Karnul is right in around 1650 AD, they migrated to Bangalore and they occupied two places. One of the the place was our BMRCL last station, right? What is that last station? Correct, you all know, right? After MG Road, right? And the other one is Chikbalapur, that is Muddenhalli. So these two places were right occupied, right, and they had to worship, right, in simple temples like the Anjaneya temple. Archak he became in Muddenhalli, his father, that is Karnool Srinivas Shastri, and he had to eke out the right money, and he had no money for advancing his education, so he had to go and study under street lights. And even today I just go to Chikbalapur, I visit his school. It's called the Kandwara Village School, where he studied. It gives me, you know, a great feeling when I see that school. So in that school, the British system was there at that time, and he studied. And he was not having a single naya paisa. He passed from that school, and he came by walk to Bangalore city. and where, you know, the Church of South India is located in Unity Building Annex. Unity Building Annex, that's one. Opposite to that, there is one school. All of you have seen, even today it is existing. So there he joined, and of course the missionaries, they encouraged him because he had no money, correct? And Sara Vishweshwaraya was encouraged by the right the CSI school, right, and given scholarships, and he could make into the right his matriculation, he could pass. After that, after seeing his great talent, then the people decided that he deserves to go for some higher studies. But that those times we had no engineering colleges. One was in Madras and the other was in Pune, and only other one in North India was Roorkee, Sir School of Surveying, and then which became School of Civil Engineering. That is only in now it is called IIT Roorkee. So these three colleges. So it made him impossible to go through his studies in Mysuru state, and therefore he had to go and take up education in Pune. In Pune, Ferguson's Pune, and he finished his BA. You have to know that BA means it is mathematics and science. BA mathematics and science. It was not given as BSc at the time. BA, and thereafter he cleared his civil engineering. He cleared his civil engineering in Kadakwasla as a student. He developed a kind of an automatic gate for the. The flooding of the Pune had happened. As a student, he gave solution for the flooding of the Pune, right? By construction of the Kadakwasla Dam as a student, correct? And he designed and developed a kind of a gate, automatic gate, which was supposed to be patented. But Sara Vishweshwaraya said, patenting is a wrong idea. My idea shall be taken free of cost for the sake of humanity across the entire world. Therefore, don't patent that. So even today, right, all civil engineers use that idea for the automatic gates for surging out the excess water from the dams to prevent the dam break. So this is what is Sara Vishweshwaraya. Now, it makes me to go back and talk one upon the other. So I will share my screen and start the webinar. So I'm starting the webinar now with a brief introduction to the two great duos. Yes. Born in Tiruthani village near Tirupati, right, Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan, correct, was actually on 5th of September. So today we have combined both the giants because 5th was a Sunday. So we had less opportunity to take up this activity. Therefore, we have combined today. So as an academician and a philosopher and a statesman, you see, ಮುತ್ಸದ್ದಿ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ, ಕನ್ನಡ ಮೇ ಮುತ್ಸದ್ದಿ ಬೋಲ್ತಾ. ಸೊ ಫಿಲಾಸಫರ್ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕತ, ರೈಟ್, ಅಂಡ್ ವಿದ್ಯಾಭ್ಯಾಸ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರ ಮೇ ಬಹುತ್ ಮೆಹನತ್ ಕ್ಯಾ ಸರ್ವಪಲ್ಲಿ ರಾಧಾಕೃಷ್ಣ ನೇ 1885 ತಕ್ಕ ಟಿಲ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ಡೇ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಹಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿಡ್ right, great service to the humanity. Was one of the most recognized and influential Indian thinkers, you call them, Indian thinkers. You always professed correct, Indianness in all his thinking, Indianness. So we are talking about new education policy today. What is that new education policy? So he had professed it in, long back. He has professed it long back. He has told about this new education policy, but today we are implementing it. And he has professed the online education in 1950s, but today we are taking up this. And throughout his life and extensive writing career, Radhakrishnan actually sought to define and defend and promulgate a religion. So what is that religion? The religion he variously identified it as Hinduism, Vedanta, and the religion of the spirit. Religion of the spirit. So that means for him, Hinduism means Islam, Hinduism means Christianity, Hinduism means Zarathustra or anything. So that means it is the free will, religion of free will. That is actually the definition of Hinduism, according to Sarvapalli. He was most non-controversial. Nobody had any controversy with him. No other country had any controversy. So whether it's Saudi or whether it is UK or US, no controversy. So non-controversial philosopher. Yes, next please. And Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan, having born right in, of course, September 5th, Tiruthani in 1888, Madras in a poor Brahmin family, as his father was Radhakrishnan, right? And poverty was the gift, right? You can see how the bright child of Radhakrishnan, right? You can see there, there's a rare photograph that we have. And Dr. Sarvapalli, right, had in Gaudi school, right? And all Christian schools he studied, and Tiruvallur, and then he went to Lutheran Mission School, Missionary Lutheran Mission School in Tirupati for his high school. He joined the Uri College in Vellore and later switched to the Madras Christian College, where he acquired his philosophy degree, right, and did his BA and MA right in it. And of course, after that, he did not get job. He did not get job. So it was right in, he joins right with great difficulty in 1907 to 1909, 2 years. He was in Anantapur as a temporary lecturer, correct, in the Government Arts College. That was the British period I'm talking about, 1907 to 1909. So 2 years he was there in Anantapur, right? Government Arts and Science College, Arts College it is called. Now, today, right, the board is there. So I happened to work in Anantapur as principal of the engineering college, right, affiliated to JNTU. And I'm proud that daily I used to pass through his department because my house was in Kamalanagar. And people told that he treaded, Sarvapalli walked across the streets. Then I was really feeling proud that I'm also walking along the streets where Sarvapalli had just walked along. So there he was, there for 2 years he worked, and people did not recognize the merit. Right, to recognize the merit, you require a great person. And that great person was Nalvadi Krishnaraj Wadiyar. Nalvadi Krishnaraj Wadiyar identified him and brings him to Mysore University, right? Now called Manasa Gangotri campus. So it was Mysore University, and makes him the vice chancellor. So those days, that is the glory of the vice chancellor. The king used to select the vice chancellor, not on any other basis, but on merit, whether he is right in Delhi or whether he is in Andhra Pradesh, that was no matter. So he was not a Kannadiga, he was a Teluguite, but even then the Maharaja of Mysore selected him because of his kind of a scholarship. His scholarship he could identify. So the Raja also should have the eyes to see, the inner eyes to see the great qualities of the scholarship and meritocracy. So, and all hats off to Maharaja of Mysore, Nalvadi Krishnaraj Wadiyar, who had the great sense, and he identifies the two people. Of course, one is Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan as the right, the vice chancellor of Mysore University, and our own Saram Vishweshwaraya as the Diwan of Mysore. You know that is a story, correct? And he is just started with assistant lecturership, right? And on daily wages basis he joined, right? And he mastered the classes of Hindu philosophy, and Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, Bhagavad Gita, Upanishads, all were in his tongues, right? And in 1918, Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan was selected as professor, right, at the University of Mysore. In 1921, of course, Radhakrishnan was nominated as a professor of philosophy at the Calcutta University. Next, please. In 1923, of course, Dr. Radhakrishnan's book, Indian Philosophy, was published. This is everybody, every Indian should read. Every Indian should read. All people of all religions should read. Then you will know what is secularism. There is Indianness and Hinduism is secularism. That is what he has professed. The book was held as the philosophical classic and a literary masterpiece by the foreign universities and prescribed in various universities of USA and other countries. And Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan was called to Oxford University once. And let me share the episode which happened. And he delivered the lecture on Hindu philosophy. And, the Queen Elizabeth, of course, was there. You know, Her Highness means everyone should sit down. Sit down. Whenever the Queen or the King of, or the British Queen or King comes, we have to sit down because we were a Commonwealth country now. We know that, we were ruled by the British. But when Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan walked, then the Queen was amazed and astonished. And she is standing up before the personality of Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan and greets him with great reverence. And that itself is a great honor for our motherland, India. That is how the Queen, for the first time, she gives respect to the Indians, Who is the ambassador? Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. So he's such a kind of a marvelous teacher, I tell you, We have to emulate his teaching techniques. Next, please. And in 1931, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan was elected as Vice Chancellor of Andhra University. And in 1939, Radhakrishnan became the Vice Chancellor of Banaras Hindu University. And in 1946, he was appointed as ambassador to UNESCO. Next, please. And he was appointed as ambassador to Soviet Union. I shared you the episode of Stalin, where he slapped. His introduction as an ambassador from India was to slap Stalin on the cheek and say, "Hello, how are you, guy?" Like that, To a dictator of the world, So what a kind of a moral strength he has got. So no fear, no favor. No fear, no favor. Only benefit the humanity. Radhakrishnan was elected as the first vice president in 1952, and he was honored with Bharat Ratna in 1954, And after, after serving two terms as vice president, 10 years, then in 1962, he was the candidate for the presidentship of India. And of course, was much appreciated by our prime minister, then prime minister, even Indira Gandhi, Next. Best known for his explanation of Indian philosophy to the West, predominantly the Advaita philosophy, and its outlook, which, like Gandhi, he interpreted as a universal religion. Advaita is the universal religion. Brahman and Atman are one and the same. So anywhere in the world you go, he is the Atman. He is the Atmasurupi. And he is the Brahman. That is the the invisible God. Invisible God and the Atman in the human being, He doesn't belong to any caste or creed. So there is no caste, no creed. It is only the Brahman in the Atman that is the manifest and the unmanifest. That is Advaita philosophy. And please note that he was the champion of the Advaita philosophy. It's an illusion that makes you think that your neighbor is someone other than yourself. Love thy neighbor like yourself. That is what the Bible says. So in a different context of Advaita, he is professing the same thing. So next, please. So philosophy, Radhakrishnan located his metaphysics with Advaita, the non-dual, and the Vedanta tradition, the Sampradaya, and like other Vedantins before him, Radhakrishnan wrote commentaries on, there are Prasthanatraya, that is the main primary text of Vedanta, Upanishads, Brahma Sutras, and the Bhagavad Gita. He had a ease with the European languages because from the childhood, his father had taught him, right, made him to learn French. And that is how he could become international giant in French, English, and Sanskrit, and Telugu, of course, his Matrabhasha, and Kannada, he learned as the Vice Chancellor of the Mysore University. Yes. Then the awards and recognitions were, he was appointed Knight and Bachelor in 31 and conferred the Sir title. Sir title is not given, but after 1947, after getting freedom, he relinquished the Sir title, he gave it back, and he just said, Dr. Radhakrishnan is enough for me. However, Sarvam Visveshwaraya retained Sir title even after the independence. 1938, elected as person of the British Academy, 54th Bharat Ratna Award, the highest civilian award, 54th the German Order, Pour Le Merit for Arts and Science, very, very prestigious one, 61 the Peace Prize of the German Book Trade, 63 the British Royal Order of Merit awarded by Queen Elizabeth II. Please note that Elizabeth is standing up before the master here. And 1968, Sahitya Academy Fellowship Award, the highest honor by Sahitya Academy. And he's the first person to get that award. And books written by Radhakrishnan, famous book is Indian Philosophy. Everyone, it should be made compulsory. Then the Hindu view of life. Hindu view of life, correct? Jawaharlal Nehru, right, says that every Indian should read this. An idealist view of life, Eastern religions and Western thoughts, religion and society, Bhagavad Gita, Dhammapada, that is Buddhism, the principle of Upanishads, recovery of faith, religion, science and culture, correct fundamentals of even Islam and Christianity, he has written. Yes, next. And some of his quotes are, only the man of serene mind, Shanti Manasu Irbeko, can realize the spirit of the meaning of life, and honesty with oneself is the condition of spiritual integrity. Integrity, integrity, integrity. Without that, how do you really explain to the world that you belong to the world? Reading a book gives us the habit of solitary reflection and true enjoyment. You should visit library and make the best use of it. Age or youth is not a matter of chronology. Don't say he's an old man, he's a young man. Please note that age is a state of mind. So don't be a fool, right? And if somebody says that he's an old man, he's a fool, because he may be having the youngest mind, and the youngest person can have a old mind, correct? Old mind without any kind of a right thinking capacity, correct? So therefore, age is not the thing. So you should not consider age. Even if he's 100 years, he could be young. So please underline this 100 times. Wealth, power, and efficiency are the appurtenances of life and not life itself. Wealth, power, and efficiency, don't consider them, right? They are just appurtenances of life. And you have just come across accidentally, right? Because of your forefathers' karma, you have become. But please note that if you do not do such activities, right, it would be purposeless and you will not be remembered, correct? And after the death. Human nature is fundamentally good, and the spread of enlightenment will abolish all the wrong. You have to spread enlightenment. Enlightenment is what? Living in the moment, living in this moment and accepting the right truth here. Accepting the truth here and taking responsibility, that is called enlightenment. Next, please. And Radhakrishnan believed that teachers should be the best minds in the country, and simply don't worship the teachers by putting vermilion mark on their heads and then use incense sticks and do puja for them. Oh, Guru, Guru, Guru. And once in a year, don't do Gurudakshina and do that. Therefore, he started University Grants Commission, right? And UGC pay scale was introduced by him. UGC pay scale was introduced by Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan to take care of the welfare of teachers. And when all the people came to him and asked, sir, I want to celebrate because you have done great service to us, right? He told, never, never do puja to me, never celebrate my birthday, but if you want to celebrate for the teachers of this entire country, you celebrate. So my birthday shall not be celebrated. It will be celebrated as Teachers' Day. As Teachers' Day, my dear friend, and the welfare of teachers. And please note that simply putting vermilion mark and show off is not the thing. You give tangible assistance to teachers, correct? For their welfare, for their family welfare, for their health. Take care. And UGC pay scales have to be implemented, correct? And his birthday has been celebrated in India as Teachers' Day on 5th September every year. And be proud that the teachers of the engineering colleges also are teachers. Right? Next. Next one is a hero of engineers. And you know, he is Bharat Ratna Saram Vishweshwaraya. And today is the birthday of Saram Vishweshwaraya, and whose name our university VTU bears. So we are proud of the VTU because Vishweshwaraya Technological University, correct? And today, right, when you go abroad, they will ask the first question, which university you come from? If you say, I am coming from VTU, please spell the name of Saram Vishweshwaraya. And believe me or not, 99.9% of our students from Karnataka cannot spell the name. It is very rather unfortunate. So in first semester, when the people join engineering, I request all our teachers to make them mug the spelling of Saram Vishweshwaraya, right? V-I-S-V-E-S-V-A-R-A-Y-A. They cannot spell this. And please note that recently, our Honorable Prime Minister has made it compulsory as one chapter for IAS, one chapter for IAS will be compulsory from last year, that is Bharat Ratna's life, Saram Vishweshwaraya, his life and works is compulsory. One question for IAS is compulsory. Let it be written down 100 times. And he was born on 15th September 1861 for our good fortune in the Muddenahalli village, now called Chikbalapur district. Those times it was called the Kolar district. Those were his Kolar district. And his father was Karnulu Srinivas Shastri, right? And his forefathers migrated to Karnataka in 1640 or so, right? 1640, correct? So, and they came to Bayapnalli and also to Muddenahalli. And there was two streams of their family. One was Bayapnalli family, Mulaknadu family, Muddenahalli Mulaknadu family. Both were priests, that is the Anjaneya temple priests. So next, please. And the mother was Venkat Lakshama. And of course, father was a Shastri, that is Sanskrit scholar. That is Karnul Srinivas Shastri. And the maternal uncle was H. Ramaya. And the elder brother was Venkatesh Shastri. And younger brother was M. Ramchandra Rao. And this was the thing. And you can see the family photo where, right, you can see, right, all the people. Yes, next. And actually, it was a very humble tiled house, correct? Right now, after Saram Vishweshwaraya became engineer, right, by his own earnings, he constructed in his village, Muddenahalli, a house. Now it has become the museum. Now it has become the museum in Muddenahalli, correct? It is under the control of our university people, correct? Yes. Bharat Ratna Sir Mokshagundam Vishweshwaraya was a great engineer, scholar and statesman, and he was invited to be Diwan of Mysore. Correct? Before he was invited as Diwan of Mysore, let me share with you that he was given assistant superintending engineer post by probation as a young graduate from Pune University, right? And he was the architect of the old Mumbai city, And he was so much honest that he was transferred and to Jabalpur. And in Jabalpur, he was responsible for the biggest railway network system. And thereafter, he was transferred to other places in North India. He was thrown in North India. He was into Bihar and everywhere, where in Patna, he constructed the Mahatma Gandhi Setu, That is the bridge across the river Ganges, Ganga River bridge. All the Biharis will say Moksha Gundam Visveshwaraya bridge. They don't say Mahatma Gandhi bridge. Then Visveshwaraya called it Mahatma Gandhi. He was transferred to Sukkur, that is undivided country, Akhanda Bharat it was, and Sukkur was, he is presently in Pakistan, right? And he constructed the famous Sukkur Dam across the Indus River in now Pakistan-controlled Punjab, and all the wealth of Pakistan, is due to this particular dam called the Sukkur Dam. And that is why Pakistan is celebrate Sarvam Visveshwaraya's birthday today as Engineers Day, like our Indians, because he gave bread and butter to the present this thing. At that time, it was not, right, undivided. It was India only. Sukkur, Sindh, Punjab. That was called Sindh, Punjab, right? And Sindhu Desh, it is called, right? And of course, he was transferred to Karachi city, Karashiva. That is the city of the Karashiva, the where at the Clifton, Karachi, you have the Shiva temple there. And Sarvam Visveshwaraya happened to take up as a sanitary engineer, chief engineer there. He developed the water supply and drainage system of Karachi city. And then he is very much acclaimed even today, right, as the architect of the Karachi city, Karashiva city. And it was our own city, right, after Mumbai city, correct? And today is not with us. And then after seeing all this, then he almost constructed 250 dams in North India. What a divine person he is. He constructs 250 dams. Nobody can imagine. Then our Maharaja of Mysore got what is this happening? I say, then Nizam of Hyderabad is calling him. And he constructed, right, the Musi River, the flood abatement system for the Hyderabad city. And then Hussein Sagar, Usman Sagar, everything he constructed, water supply system for Hyderabad city, he constructed, correct? And the entire Hyderabad city is telling, Nizam of Hyderabad is appreciating. And why Mysore state is not honoring this young engineer? Then Nalvadi Krishna Raja Wadiyar's eyes saw this young engineer, correct? At the age of 32, 34 itself, he has accomplished so many things. And then he requests Bharat Ratna Moksha Gundam Visveshwaraya, sir, you please come here. Our Mysore require your services. Our Mysore requires your services. Then he agrees and comes to Mysore. But whatever it is, correct, he asks one question to the king. And he sits comfortably with him without any fear or favor again. And he asks one question. Okay, Nalvadi Krishnaraj Wadiyar, sir, it is okay. I will come here, but with one condition, that I will ask you money. And this is for the humanity. And you have to give me. Otherwise, I will not come to Mysore, he will say. Then after hearing this, and Nalvadi Krishnaraj Wadiyar takes it as a challenge, and then in fact pledges the queen's ornaments, the gold ornaments and diamonds, silver, everything, right, with a pawnbroker in Mumbai city, everything he is pledging, and then gives the money to Sarvam Visveshwaraya to construct so many things, and the best of which is the KRS Dam, Kannambadikatte. Then the whole of the humanity, the Mysuru province, what you call the, now it is called Karnataka, right, became rich and resplendent, right? He started State Bank of India, of Mysore. State Bank of Mysore he started. And he started the colleges, University College of Engineering, right? UCE, now called UVCE. Then SJ Polytechnic. And those times itself, he started cinematography. He introduced mechanical engineering. He said mechanical engineering is the most important branch of engineering without which you cannot prosper. That is what he appointed the principal of University Vishwaswara Engineering College, first engineering college, as a chief engineer of PWD, was a mechanical engineer. Correct? And please note that he started so many things, and his achievements, I'll be telling it later. Life and journey of the legendary, early schooling in Chikbalapur, 1881 BA examination, and 83 civil engineering science, Pune, ranked first in CCE, FCE examination, that is the licentiate in civil engineering, you call it, upgraded to the degree as first class. Correct? Next, please. Then he was called the father of modern Mysuru state. Father of modern Mysuru state. Mysuru means now Karnataka state. He encouraged private investment in the industry during the tenure of Diwan of Mysore, and he was instrumental in charting out the plan for road construction between Tirumala and Tirupati. And one thing I would like to remember is that even at the age of 102 years, J.R.D. Tata told that he will be heading the TISCO, that is the Tata Iron and Steel in Jamshedpur, that is Tata Nagar. So please note that even right in the last day of his death, right, J.R.D. Tata believed that he is a young brain. So 102 year old young man, he called J.R.D. Tata. So that is what. So even like Sarvepalli, our Saram Vishwaswaraya also says that it is a state of mind. Youth is a state of mind. Be youthful always. Be at 100 years, be a young man. Serve the nation, serve the country, serve humanity. Next. So what did he do? His vision was eliminate unemployment and poverty through engineered service. This is the vision of Saram Vishwaswaraya. What was the vision of Sarvepalli? Eliminate unemployment and poverty through education. That is Sarvepalli. And the major milestones of Saram Vishwaswaraya is built Old Mumbai City, Sukkur Dam now in Pakistan, Punjab across Indus River, Aden, the Seri city water supply, using rainwater harvesting. Today you are talking about rainwater harvesting, but he just did it in 1940s. Hyderabad, Musi River spate prevention, Usman and Hussain Sagar projects in Hyderabad, built 250 dams in North India, Mahatma Gandhi Setu in Patna, implemented divisional system of irrigation, world famous KRS dam, automatic gate system, then Jog Sharavati hydroelectric project, what not, next please. And after his graduation, I have already dealt all these things, correct? Is no need to this thing. But the Vishakhapatnam port was in danger of being eroded from the sea, and Vishwaswaraya, with his high intelligence and capabilities, came up with good solution and solved this and saved the Vizag port, you call it. During the decade of 1900s, Hyderabad city was reeling under the threats and flood. And once again, a brilliant engineer supervised the engineering work at Hyderabad by lending his services as a special consulting engineer. 1909, my dear friends. He was appointed as the chief engineer of the Mysore state in 1909 and as Diwan of princely state of Mysore in 1912. When he was appointed as Diwan, one episode I have to tell you. What is that episode? Then he calls all his mother, family, everybody, and gives very good food, right? In his family, right? If somebody is giving good food, everyone would be happy. First, that is the thing that in his family. Then he gives an address. Look, I am taking up the Diwan because the king has ordained me. Correct? I will not take up this Diwan. If you people come, the relatives and friends and the caste people, creed people, all these people, if you come and ask me some for favors, then I will not take this. Then if you promise me, then only I will take. Then after getting the promise from his mother and his relatives, he takes up the Diwan. And also he was uncomfortable as a Diwan, right? Because his work was not executed by the king sometimes. And he resigned the post of Diwan. He resigned the post of Diwan. And that is what Saram is. He helped in founding Government Engineering College and later renamed as UVCE. And he served as chief engineer for construction of the Krishnaraj Sagar project 1924 across River Kaveri in Mandya district. And until that time, right, Tamil Nadu had no kind of a problem with Karnataka. After his death, right, this Kaveri dispute has come. Because there is nobody to argue, right, in a technical way. And as stunt engineer Bombay City, 1885, and services lent to municipality of Sukkur, Dam Singh, Punjab, now in Pakistan, executive engineer Surat, 1896, assistant superintendent engineer Pune, 1887 to 1899, visited China, Japan, and gave designs for Chinese and Japanese and US people. 1898, Hungry Hearts Dam. Guru Ramaswamy Iyengar says that when they visited Guru Ramaswamy Iyengar, USA, then one question was asked at the Hungry Hearts Dam in USA. What is that question? The question asked is, like, do you know Saram Vishweshwaraya? A security man at the gate of Hungry Hearts Dam is asking. Then Guru Ramaswamy Iyengar was surprised. What is this man asking this question? Then he said, Sarami had already died 6 years back, sir. And then he told that this Hungry Hearts Dam was designed by Saram Vishweshwaraya in USA. Correct? One of the longest dams those times. And he became the chief sanitary engineer of Mumbai City and also the member sanitary board 1901, gave evidence before the Indian Irrigation Commission, designed and constructed automatic gates, and and did not take patent. He was against taking patents because it would really, you know, not in favor of humanitarian service. Taking patent is not a humanitarian service, he found. Right? Lake life storage reservoir, that is, introduced a new system, the block systems, and superintending engineer 1907, visited Egypt, Canada, United States, Russia, Yemen. He constructed the dam and hydroelectric project in Yemen, and consulting engineer to Hyderabad Nizam and the Musi River projects. Retired from British service. He was in British service 1909. He retired. Chief engineer and secretary to government of Mysore, 1909. Diwan of Mysore. Then, okay, next please. Then major established institutions, right, he did was UVC, Federation of Commerce, FICCI, you call it on Kempegowda Road. Go and see FICCI, Federation of Industries and Commerce. Who did it? This is Saram Vishweshwaraya. Leather tanning, that is Mysore Chrome Tanning Company. Mysore Iron and Steel Works, Bhadravati. Mysore Paper Mills, Bhadravati. Mysore Lock and Paints. Mysore Silk Industries, MSIL, and State Bank of Mysore. Sandalwood and Oil Factory, KS&DL, Technological Museum, Century Club, Bangalore. Please note that Vishweshwaraya said engineers should not simply worship human beings. They should work, work, work. And work is worship. And after working hard, they should go and enjoy in the Century Club. He started the Century Club. He constructs the Century Club. He started the Century Club in Bangalore in Kappan Park and says that engineers should enjoy. And that is what Saram Vishweshwaraya. So there was a lot of difference between the Gandhian technologies and Saramis. He said industrialize or perish. That is Saram Vishweshwaraya. Then Central Library, then SJ Polytechnic, cinematography, mechanical engineering are most important for the future of India. You have to use cinematography for educating the masses, he said. University of Agriculture Science, Hebbal, he created, and HAL, his forethought and vision is Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, right? That is forethought of Saram Vishweshwaraya. Next, please. Then, considering his merit, all people gave except Mysore University, and later they gave. The Kolkata University, Patna University, Andhra University, Jadavpur University, Bombay University, Duranya University, Allahabad University gave the PhDs. After seeing this, Mysore University also conferred the doctorate on Saram Vishweshwaraya. Next. Some of the honors and laurels conferred is honorary membership of London Institution of Civil Engineers and CIE, Companion of the Indian Empire, 1915 KCIE, Knight Commander of the Order of the Indian Empire, 1921 DSC, Doctor of Science from Calcutta University, right, LLD, Doctor of Law, right, from Bombay University, 1937, D.Litt from Banaras Hindu University, 43, elected as honorary life member of Institution of Engineers India, 44, Doctor of Science, Allahabad University, 1948, doctorate and doctor of law from Mysore University, D.Litt from Andhra University, 1953, 53, awarded honorary fellowship of the Institute of Town Planners India, 55, conferred Bharat Ratna, 1955, conferred Bharat Ratna, the gem of India, the highest distinction of the country, and 58, Doctor of Science from Jadavpur University, 58, Durga Prasad Kaitan Memorial Gold Medal by the Royal Asiatic Society. Next, please. And some of the photographs I will just run through and close this session, and bearing with me, thank you very much. This is, as a student, how vibrant he was. Sara Vishwasharaya, the first photo. The second photo is as assistant superintendent engineer in Mumbai city with a turban, and Saravi, that is in Mysuru, right, as the chief engineer, the Mysore city, right, the Samstan, and Saravi as Diwan of Mysore. Then is a rare photo without turban and conferment of Bharat Ratna by
Tarhan.
Rajendra Prasad, and please. And this is the 99th birth anniversary. Sir Mirza Ismail, greeting 99th. He is coming, standing and coming, this thing. Right? And I have to tell you, when my teacher, K.G. Krishnamurthy sir, mathematics teacher in the high school, he taught me, right? He said, when he went when he was doing MSc, he wanted to meet Saram Vishwasharaya. He goes and his house, but he doesn't allow. He told, I will not allow because I have to be dressed well to meet people. To give the respect to the people, I have to be dressed well. The dress code is most important. If the dress code is good, your mind will be good. Your heart will be good. So always be having, you know, this thing. So 102 years before his death, he was having this dress code, and he gave right permission to meet him at age of 102 with a turban on his head. So please note, Saramvi was such a vibrant young man of 102 years, and he created what is called the SBM. You see this building. By the side of that, there is one granite building. That is contribution, the State Bank of Mysuru, and now it is SBI, State Bank of India. And all these people say, innovation, innovation, innovation. What is this electric car project? He did it in 1952, electric car project for carbon footprint mitigation. My dear friend, he calls Mr. G.C. Naidu, his friend, and he starts the electric car company in 1952 in Coimbatore. So what is the innovation what we are doing here now? So please note that was done in 1952 to take up carbon footprint mitigation. So that is the photo of the electric car that was designed by Sara Vishwasharaya and manufactured by G.C. Naidu and company Coimbatore. Yes, next please. And this is the centurion. As a 100-year-old man, he is coming and greeting all the people, Sara Vishwasharaya. And please note, he is such a humble person. Sara Vishwasharaya was such a humble person. See that Kengal Hanumanthaya comes to his house. When he comes to his house, Kengal is a very young person, very young person. But even then, right, he is the chief minister of the state of Karnataka. Therefore, he takes out his hat and hats off to Kengal, he says. Hats off to Kengal, he says. What do we learn from this? Even if our boss is younger than us, you have to honor his pita, you have to honor his chair. That is what Saram Vishwasharaya says. Right? I may be having 40 years of experience, correct? I have to honor my boss, correct? I have to honor my boss because that is the pita, that is not the person, that is the chair that we have to honor. So that is what you can see, hats off to Kengal. So he's removing his hats like the British system and then doing namaskar to Kengal Hanumanthaya, who's a very young person. Yes. And 1924, MISL, by the way, that is the iron and steel works he visits. And when Krishnaraj Wadiyar died, his mentor died, and Saram Vishwasharaya could not prevent his tears. He conducted a meeting, he was in Mumbai, and morning meeting in 1940 with all the great people of the country, and he is hailing Nalvadi Krishnaraj Wadayar as a seer. So this is 1948 Mysore University, where he gets the doctorate, 1944 the doctorate from Patna University. And of course, you see, anybody can identify KR Circle, right? He started right the SJ Polytechnic. Now it is of course become and right opposite to that is UVCE. And Jawaharlal Nehru calls him, and right at the 100th year, right, so in his presence a stamp was released. And when Bharat Ratna was awarded, I have to share something thoughts here. So when Bharat Ratna was awarded, Saram Visveshwarya refused to take Bharat Ratna because he did not like the Nehruvian policy. Even then, Saram Visveshwarya was asked to come and accept this. But Saram V says that there is one condition. What is this condition? After taking Bharat Ratna, I will condemn the policies of Nehru, he says, because it is not good for the country, correct? And that is the irrigation policy was flawed. So that is what Saram V says. But Jawaharlal Nehru is such a great person. He's a great person. He says, Saram V, please accept this and criticize me. So what a statesman Jawaharlal Nehru is. He's such a great person he is. He says that criticize me after taking Bharat Ratna. Then Bharat Ratna was conferred on Saram Visveshwaraya, and after that he gives a public speech, and in that he criticizes some of the policies of the Nehru government. And that is what, and Nehru accepts it. Nehru accepts it. That is what two great people are about. So whenever somebody is criticizing you, it is for the welfare of humanity, you should understand. If the boss doesn't understand the people down him, criticizing him, he will not grow. He is not a good boss. He's a bad boss. So that is what this thing. So Nehru was a very good boss, and of course, a great chief engineer he was, right, Saram Visveshwaraya. Kannambadi Katta, you can see how glorious it is in 1920. Next, please. Then important books are written, and of which two are very important. Planned Economy for India, even today it is valid, 1861-62. And the Memoirs of My Working Life. Yeah, all of you have to see. Unemployment in India, remove unemployment. And India should become the, right, what should the exporter of food to the world, he said. And he gave the Ganga Kaveri Link Canal system, which could not be implemented by Nehru. And that is the difference in opinion. So if it had been done, 50 years it would be, right, it would take for India. And in 50 years, India would have been the richest country. That, I think, unfortunately, our governments and subsequent governments have not given thought. Next. Patriot, if I were to be a sweeper, I would be the best sweeper in the world. That is Saram Visveshwaraya. Love your motherland, Saram Visveshwaraya. Be young till death. Be young till death, I say. Don't say that, no, he is a very young officer. What? He doesn't have anything in the brain. Be young till death. You should be creative. And youth is state of mind, not of age. Please, please note, there are some youth here, correct? They are already dead. Their brain is dead. What is the use of such youth? So youth is state of mind, not of age, Saram Visveshwaraya. Now, thank you very much for having a patient listening of the two great duos of India and not of India. Of...
Sorry, I mean, yaar kadra karskobaka, laptop
fundi diya. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much, sir. And I thank my honorable chairman, sir, who has always blessed me here, Dr. Kalluri Ramakrishna Paramahansa, sir, for all the help that he has given for delivering this talk. He himself is a great pioneer, right? And what I should say, a great academician, and what I should say, he is an industry, academy and industry, right, are brought in par. And of course, he is a very disciplined personality and very well read from PhD from California University. He is our honorable chairman. So, and I salute you, sir, for encouraging me to deliver this talk. And I also give salutations to our respected honorable vice chairperson, Srimati Geeta Madam, right, for all this help that she has been rendering to us, and Miss Monica Madam, who is the vice president of the Paramahansa Foundation Trust, for all the encouragement, and of course our beloved executive vice president, Rahul sir, who himself is studied in Stanford University and of course in London universities, right, and he has been a great young force here and a great visionary, we can call it, and changing the system into a modern system. So I salute all my professors, HODs, students, and all the people who have come here, Dr. Vasant Chandra, and of course from US, right, people and from Washington have joined, and people from Detroit have joined. I thank all of you, right, across the world who have joined and, you know, heard me from Bombay University, from Delhi University, from Pune, right, then Amity University, and all the people. And before I conclude, I announce that on today, right, I have announced the awards for the PhD scholar, and the best PhD thesis goes to Dr. B.N. Skandakumar of Jyoti Institute of Technology, and we are going to have a function for delivering all this to them. And today, just notionally, I say, and Dr. Vinay from IIT Kharagpur, right, he gets the best PhD award for the Western Ghats work on Western Ghats he has done. And of course, all other people, right, who have worked, Dr. Guruswami and Dr. Shaukat Ali Khan Zai sir, and Dr. Divya Srinath, Dr. Ajit Sabni sir, Dr. Vaiya Narayan Swami sir, and all the people, right, who have helped in this kind of an endeavor. And we are going to honor them, right, on this particular day, right. So I thank all of you. And with this permission may be granted to me to close this session, I over to Dr. Girish sir. Girish sir is here, our honorable principal sir. So,
sir, thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Thank
you. It was a talk of wisdom, sir. It actually crossed all the knowledge and it has reached the wisdom, sir. So you are an ocean of a knowledge, sir. Thank you very much. On behalf of AMC Engineering College, I thank Dr. Shashi Shankar, sir, HOD Civil Engineering, for his very beautiful speech. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Sir, thank you. I think our Jagannath, Chief Engineer ISRO, has joined. And okay. I think from Jagannath, sir. Jagannath.
Sir, actually, I want to say one important thing here. To me, Professor Shashi Shankar, sir, is one great Kannada, writer, being an engineer. Sir, today it was a treat, about 70 plus students and research scholars and colleagues. You gave such a befitting memories of Saram V. And his statement was very simple, sir. Plan your work, work your plan. When people asked him to give message to younger generation, I think I want to end by saying that our elders live in us and science is in our breath. And you have shown this in words, sir. Thank you very much. Namo Namaha.
Dr. B.L. Shukumar, sir, my teacher is here, sir. I welcome Dr. B.L. Shukumar. Always is
there. Congratulations. Congratulations. Very informative webinar. Youth. You have spoken about youth.
Yes,
so
sir.
We have to be always young.
Yes.
And
yes.
Be active.
Yes,
I congratulate you. And I wish you happy Engineers Day. To all the AMC and all, God bless you.
Yes, sir. This thing, sir. Vasant Chandra, sir. Rotarian, Vasant Chandra, sir. Yes.
Yes, it was a very enlightening things about the two great people. I, though Indian, at the age of 70 now, still not know many of the things mentioned today. Very, very thankful and grateful. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Shaukat, sir. Dr. Shaukat.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Great enlightenment has been given about all the teachers and the children. It is helpful for each and every youngster, sir. Thank you very much, sir, for your honorable speech.
Thank you. I thank all the professors, and anybody who would like to just say a few words can do. Dr. Venkat Lakshmi, madam. Dr. Bhanu Prakash. Dr. Goswami.
Yes, sir. Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, yes.
Sir, words are not sufficient to explain your expression, sir. God bless you with good health and happiness, sir. Once again,
Thank you. God bless you, sir.
Very Thank nice session, sir.
Thank
very
you.
Nice session, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you all.
Thank you, Dr. Lata. Thank you, Dr.
Sir, thank you very much, sir. I'm Venkat Lakshmi here, sir.
Yeah. Tell me, madam.
Sir, it's a wonderful session, very informative, energetic session, and we have learned many things from your presentation, which we were not aware of also.
So thank you so much, sir,
for spending your valuable time and delivering the valuable speech to all of us.
I'm humbled, madam. I'm humbled. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
Dr. Bhanu Prakash, sir, yes.
Sir, it was an excellent information. All of us have got our knowledge being enriched. We would like to profusely thank for your kind gesture and sharing your knowledge with everybody. I once again take this opportunity to thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.